Welcome friends, today we are going to take another important inventory control mechanism that is known as economic order quantity. As we are dealing with the series of production management in which I have told you that what is production planning and control, what is inventory control, what is inventory management system, ABC, and now today we are going to get another topic that is known as economic order quantity. Economic order quantity is very important because it is one of the most refined inventory statistical tools which helps the production manager to know about that at what time he has to give the order and how he is going to contain that order, means raw material, for a specific purpose. Now let's understand and explore that what is economic order quantity. So here let's see, economic order quantity, that is also known as EOQ, is a model used in inventory management to determine the optimal order quantity that a company should purchase to minimize the total cost of inventory. Means here we are going to determine the optimal cost, the cost at which the company should buy or give order for the stocks, that is for the inventory, so that he can get the best price at its cost. Then this model takes into account the cost of ordering and holding inventory as well as the cost of stockouts. Means holding cost is very important, because whatever raw material you are going to buy, you have to keep that raw material into a specific warehouse, and for that you have to give certain transportation price also to get that raw material from the area of production to your unit, to your company. So here this is known as the holding cost, and the other one is known as the ordering cost, means at what time you are going to order so that the stocks which are there in the warehouse should be properly used, and the stocks which are going to come should have got a place in the warehouse. So here this system is all what we are going to see in the economic order quantity. So by the term, as you all know, two things are there which is very important. The first one is the holding cost and the second one is the ordering cost. So holding cost are the cost associated with the storing and maintaining inventory. Means the way you are going to store the inventory, where you are going to store the inventory, and the second one is maintaining inventory. Means you have to see that whatever inventory you have got, whatever raw material you have got, it must have got proper time to be converted into finished good. So these two timing are very important. And when according to these two times you are going to give the orders, such as warehouse, spaces, insurance and depreciation. As you all know that whenever we are going to buy a product, whether it is a raw material for any company, there is a depreciation which always goes on. So a production manager must have to take into consideration that the product which he is going to buy should have a minimum depreciation cost. Means if he wants that a project should be used in the month of June, automatically he should have that product in the month of May, so that it reduces the cost of warehousing, it reduces the cost of insurance, as well as depreciation is also being reduced. So the next one is the ordering cost. Ordering costs are the cost associated with the placing of an order for inventory. At what cost you are going to place the order? Raw material, the cost of raw material changes with the change in the environment, with the change in the market, with the change in the demand and supply of a product. So at what time you are going to give the order is very important, because ordering cost depends upon the time which is favorable for a production manager to give the order. Now, such as the cost of processing the order, transportation cost and any discount or bulk purchasing cost. Means here it is very important, three factors are being considered over here. The first one is the processing of the order. When you are going to place an order and at what time you are going to receive the order, what time it takes, what is the cost of transportation which is going to be there, means the price at which the product is going to be at your place, at the place where the company is situated, from the place where the, we are buying the raw material. And the third one is that the discount which we are getting while we are having a bulk purchase. Is there any discount which we are getting? Is there a number of raw material sellers who are there in the market who are selling us the best raw material? What is the quantity which we should have to maintain? And this quantity must have a proper standard that is known as the quality of the product. So there must be a match between the quality and the quantity of the product. This must be determined by a production manager. As a production manager, these two costs, that is known as holding cost and ordering cost, is very important whenever you are going to calculate the economic order quantity. Now let's see that what is the formula for economic order quantity. How you are going to calculate the economic order quantity? So the formula of economic order quantity is under root, bracket open bracket close, 2ds upon h. Here d stands for annual demand for the item. Means what is the demand of an item for that specific annual year. So here the demand which is there, you are going to put it over here. 2 is a constant value. S, cost of placing an order. As I have told you that what is ordering cost. So here what is the cost of ordering that specific raw material, we are going to put it over here, and divided by the holding cost. Holding cost of 1 unit per year means if you are going to make a product and that final product you have to keep it in the warehouse or you have to send it to the market. So what is the cost of that specific single product for that specific year to be kept in a warehouse or to be sent in the market should be placed over here. So whenever we are going to calculate this, we are going to get our economic order quantity, means the best quantity, the best price at which we are going to order, so that our business used to have a maximum utilization of resources, as well as we are going to get the best MRP for our product. So now, importance of EOQ. Why we are going to use this in our system? The first one is in detail. The economic order quantity model can help companies to minimize the total cost of inventory and improve customer services by ensuring that they always have enough inventory to hand to meet the customer's demand. Whenever we are talking about the retail management, we always used to have to see that in any business, and specific in retail management, there must be a proper balance between the demand and supply. So EOQ helps a retailer to have a proper demand and supply mechanism working for a system, because he has to take the product from the warehouse, from the wholesaler. So whenever there is a demand, before the demand, he should have a product in his store, in his retail market. The second is in manufacturing. The economic order quantity can help companies to minimize the cost associated with ordering and holding raw materials and improve efficiency by ensuring that they always have the necessary materials on hand to meet the production needs. Means whenever we are talking about the manufacturing unit, as you all know that in manufacturing unit, what happens? Manufacturing units convert certain raw material into finished good. So it is very important for a production manager to have a proper inventory mechanism system, that at what time the raw material should be bought, how much raw material should be bought, so that it reduces the ordering cost as well as reduces the holding cost, and how it can be converted into the finest product and must be sent to the market for the use. So by reducing all the cost, you are going to get the best cost, that is known as the economic order quantity. So it is very important for the manufacturing unit also. Now in healthcare, the economic order quantity model can be used to manage the inventory of the medical supplies, helping hospitals and clinics to minimize costs and ensures that they always have enough supplies on the hand to meet the patient need. Again, in healthcare also, The same things are going to be handled. Means, whenever we are going to deal with the patients, there are different medicines, there are different types of products which is being required by the patient to give him health care. So, for doctors, it is very important that they should have a proper understanding upon the medicines, about the different products, about the surgical products which they have to be in their hospitals, so that it should be used in the proper manner whenever required by the patient. So in healthcare also, it is very important. It is being determined that EOQ is very helpful in healthcare. And the next one is in logistic. In logistic, the EOQ model can be used to manage the inventory of shipping and packaging materials, helping companies to minimize costs and ensures that they always have enough materials on hand to meet the shipping needs. Means whenever in logistic we are shipping our product inventory, whether we are carrying our materials, so in logistic, all this process must be properly maintained by the help of EOQ. That at what time the shipping cost, at what time the inventory should be sent to shipping, when the ship is going to reach the harbor, at what place you are going to collect your raw material and you are bringing it to your company. So everything must be finalized by the help of EOQ. Now, advantages of using EOQ model. The first one is minimize total inventory cost. The best thing which EOQ helps a production manager is minimizes the inventory cost. How? Because by the help of economic order quantity, a person used to have a balance between the holding cost and the ordering cost. So, whenever you have got a balance between these two, automatically you are going to minimize the inventory cost. Then improves customer services. As I have told you that inventory must have a proper quality mechanism system. So whenever you are going to be very strict with the quality standards, automatically the byproduct or the final product is up to the standard, and this standard product is being acceptable to the customer, providing the customer as a delight. So automatically the satisfaction of the customer increases, and this helps to improve the customer services. Then easy to use. As you know that in EOQ you have only got two values you have to calculate, that is ordering cost and holding cost. So when a person knows about the holding cost and ordering cost, automatically he can apply the EOQ. So it is very easy to use the EOQ. Can be used in conjunction with other inventory management techniques. As there are different inventory management techniques, ABC, VED, GIT. ABC, always better control, activity based costing. VED, vital, essential, desirable. GIT, just in time. So there are different inventory management tools. So here every inventory management tool has got a limitation and advantages. But by the help of EOQ, as we are going to calculate the cost, the best cost, the minimum cost, the economical cost. So this is very helpful for other management system, other inventory system, which is important for a better production management system. Then helps to improve forecasting. As you all know that when we have got the knowledge of our product, when we have got the knowledge of our maximum retail cost or the cost at which the product is going to be produced, so automatically the cost of production, when it is being known by a production manager, automatically it helps to improve the forecasting mechanism. Then helps in setting inventory levels. At what time you are going to place the order for raw material? At what time you are going to reorder your raw material? At what price you are going to get your raw material? What are the quality standards and quantity standards which must be maintained? So this is this EOQ helps in setting this system. Then helps in determining the required point. As I have told you that by the help of EOQ, both the holding cost and ordering cost is being recorded. So by the help of EOQ, the main advantage is this, that it helps in determining the required point. At which point the production manager should reorder the inventory, reorder the raw material, and at what time he has to see that the cost of transportation is minimum. He has to see that there is no wastage in the raw material. He has to see that proper warehouse management system must be taken care of. So all these things must be properly measured to have a better economic order quantity. So these are some of the advantages of economic order quantity. Now let's understand that what are the disadvantages, because when there is an advantages, there are also disadvantages. So first is assume constant demand. So here, whenever we are talking about EOQ, we only talk about the cost. We are not working with the demand and supply of a mechanism of a market. So it is not necessary that whatever product you are making has a constant demand in the market, because as there is a product cycle which goes on. Sometimes the demand of the product is very high and sometimes the demand lacks. So as there is no constant demand, so EOQ doesn't matches with the demand and supply mechanism of the market. So this is one of the main drawbacks of EOQ. Second, neglects lead time. Lead time is what time? The time at which you are going to reorder your quantity of raw material, the time it will take from ordering to getting the product, and from getting the product to the processing of product. So this is the lead time. So here in EOQ, in the formula of EOQ, there is no standard time frame. It lacks about the time frame. The formula doesn't say that it considers that time, lead time into its formula. Clear? Third one is the constant cost. Constant cost means whenever we are applying the EOQ, we assume that the cost of the product is always a constant. The raw material cost is somewhat constant. We say that the holding cost is somewhat constant. Yes, ordering cost has got some ups and downs according to the market changes. So, but here in EOQ, we assume that it's a constant cost. So, it is one of the drawback of the EOQ. No stockout cost. No stockout cost means sometimes we order the raw material, but the raw material doesn't reach on time. And our raw material in the warehouse is finished. So there is an impact on the production system. Why? Because in machines, there is no raw material, so they are not going to produce any product. So this is what a wastage of a mechanism is going on. So by the help of EOQ, we cannot determine that what is the wastage, what is the wastage we are getting if we have got the stock out. Now the next point is only one item. Only one item means, as I have told you, that holding cost and ordering cost is being determined over here. So if for a production unit you required more than one raw material, you required multiple raw material, so for each and every raw material you have to calculate different EOQs. So it is one of the drawback that only one item is being considered once when we are going to calculate the EOQ. For a multiple product, for a multiple raw material, you cannot apply it. For multiple raw material, for multiple inventories, you have to calculate EOQ of each and every item in different manner. Then the last one is simplicity. Means it is very simple. Anyone can use it. So this is a drawback. Why? Because it only deals with the costing mechanism. It doesn't deal with the unit or the quantity aspect. So somewhere or other, these are the drawbacks of the economic order quantity. So economic order quantity is overall a very good inventory mechanism system, because it tells you about the cost at which you are getting your raw material. And if a good manager knows that what is the final cost of a raw material and how he is going to process that raw material. The processing cost he knows, and after that the delivering cost he knows. So the whole process helps a production manager to keep the best cost for his product so that it has been acceptable to the customer and the demand of that product is highly in the market. So EOQ helps a production unit or a company to determine the cost of the product, and on the basis of this the final MRP is drawn out. So somewhere or the other, EOQ is one of the most important aspect for the whole production system. As again I am telling you that we are dealing with a series of inventory management system, and in these inventory management systems we are going to deal with the different inventory models. In the past lectures, who have missed it, please go through ABC analysis, inventory management, and this is EOQ. I hope you have understood. Thank you.